My research focuses on information and communication technologies and how do you reduce the energy requirements by these systems and technologies. And today these systems consume 8 to 12 or even up to 15% of the world energy. And we are working towards reducing them through understanding, for instance, data center energy or in general communication energy. But the research also has another side to it, which is reducing energy required for wireless portable devices, particularly in the context of biosensing or neural sensing. All of us are going to have 100 devices per person or 1,000 devices per person in 15 or maybe even 5 years by some estimates. So what we'll need to do is have a more systematic approach, a more theory-guided approach, which helps us design systems that effectively work in all different situations. We are working with the right set of people, engineers, neuroscientists, doctors, circuit designers. And what we are doing is we are coming up with novel strategies that question the fundamental limits that had been established a long time back. The biggest problem that we are facing today is that there is no single modality in neuroscience that lets you capture the dynamics of the brain signal, both at high spatial accuracy and high temporal accuracy. So you can quickly locate how the brain activity is moving around in the brain. There is no one technique that does it, and what we need is one portable technique that does it. And the hope is that these kinds of devices will enable not just better brain-machine interfaces, but also better diagnosis of many diseases such as epilepsy. I'm really impressed with the quality of both undergraduate and graduate students at CMU. The way my lab is structured is we collaborate heavily with undergraduate students in interaction with practice. And then graduate students and myself focus primarily on theoretical results and obtaining new theory for these practical problems that are relevant today.